And today the technology, and this is actually a really crazy thing, there are tools like something called generative design. This to me is one of the most important areas of technology that I want my kids to understand. You know, in the 80s, I remember my mother, she wanted me to learn golf and Japanese because those were like the language of business, and I didn't do either. And today it's Mandarin and coding. And all I know is that in 10 years, it'll be something totally different, right? That parents are prescribing that just won't really matter. Generative design is a not well understood application in technology where I basically say, Mike, I need a hinge for a door, and it's got to go from this to this angle. And, you know, do you have that in stock? And you're going to say no. Well, now I can actually go to the computer program and it can generate mathematically. It can evolve, looking at all the different possibility spaces and looking at the constraints and the weight and the price that I'm willing to pay and the material design. And the computer program will basically evolve the part. And then you can print that. So what that means is that we're going to basically be putting in the problem. The computer is going to be designing the thing that normally would look like these platonic solids in geometric shape. And the world is going to start to look more like H.R. Giger and this sort of flowy architecture as opposed to the rigid structures that we have. And I think that's also going to be profound just in design and architecture and building and product making.
Well, that's a classic challenge, right? I mean, why are houses built the way they're built? Because right angles are very easy for unskilled laborers to measure.
And 2x4s are easy to produce and consistent. Yeah, absolutely.
And so all that begins to change in the world that you think is relatively near ahead.
And not only near ahead, but I think you're starting to see it in small forms. You know, this hinge is an example. There's a part for BMW that's being made by one of our companies up in Boston called Desktop Metal, which produces 3D printed metal. And it looks like it's out of an alien movie. It looks like Gaudi would have designed it. I mean, it's organic, it's flowing, which makes sense, right? I mean, Mother Nature and evolution designed all kinds of complex structures, but they don't look anything like these right-angled, you know, platonic solids.